fourth episode of Kettlebell Sport Training Composition, and today we'll do a tactic program. In previous episode, we did strategy programming, where we was organized our 1 year sport year, which named macro cycle. And so tactic programming that we'll do today, that's what called a mesocycle, which usually about 8 to 12 weeks long, and actually that's usually how long it takes us to prepare for competitions. Well, in kind of simple name for it is a training cycle. So we have three exercises in kettlebell sport: long cycle, jerk, and snatch. And in modern kettlebell sport, actually right now it's way more options of for competitions, because on the past times, well, we still had three kettlebell sport exercises, but only two sports, and first one was long cycle and second one was biathlon, which means that when you're in biathlon training cycle, you do jerk and snatch together. But right now we see that triathlon getting stronger, where athletes do all three exercises at one competitions, and also individual events available now where you can compete in jerk only or in snatch only. So again, a bit more freedom, but still, well, as I was mentioned before, and as we can see, well, by this timing that in 1 year we can fit about 5 to 6 training cycles, and ideally switch exercises from one training cycle to another. And again, today I will show you what exactly, well, how exactly the training process organized in this mesocycle, what's happened in this 8-12 weeks, where it's a good time to make a main test, where, how much time you have to increase the weight from the light weights to your training weight. So, well, let's go through it together. When it comes to programming for long cycle and jerk, that's quite similar rules. But when it comes to snatch, it's different. So that's why let's start with programming for long cycle and jerk first. And we have our 12 weeks, and by the end of these 12 weeks, we'll have our 10-minute set. And again, well, that's the amount of time that by sports science is the best amount that long enough to get to your best shape. And it's not good to spend longer time for one competition preparation, because it's way too long to keep increasing the volume and difficulty of the training. And well, if you will take shorter time, well, you will have not enough time to get to your best shape. 8 to 12 weeks are quite a big delta, and well, you have it because it depends on some other factors. Well, first of all, your calendar, because sometimes we just physically haven't 12 weeks between competitions and we have less. So again, at 8, that's kind of minimum. At least 8 weeks you need to kind of just build up your shape and readiness for competitions. And if there is no rush and you're able to choose the date of competition, well, better to say not a date of competition, but day when you can start your preparation for competition. So 12 weeks, that's ideal. That's where with no rush you can have enough time to start with light weights, work on technique, build up to your competition weight, spend time on your competition weight belts, get used to it, and make all necessary test trainings, and get to your competition final set. Kettlebell sport programming, as programming for any other sport, that's art, and well, there is improvising there, but there is the rules. of the games and some what we call the checkpoints, some fundamental workouts that must be present in your training cycle. And what we have here in our training cycle is it should be a place for your main test set before competitions, your final check. In kettlebell sport, we never do 10-minute set with competition weight bells during the training cycle through this 8 to 12 weeks. Well, maximum as long as we go is for 8 minutes. And if you want to do your main test set 8 minutes long, it should be 3 weeks before competitions. Well, that's how much time you need to kind of mostly mentally recover before your competition set. Or if you want to do 7-minute long test, well, it can be 2 weeks before competitions. And as you can see, I wrote it should be or 8 minutes or 7. It shouldn't be both of them. So you pick something one. Also, you can see, well, this line shows us well, the volume and difficulty of the work. And last week in long cycle and jerk, volume goes down. It's usually no any challenge in your trainings, and competition usually happens by the end of the week. Mostly that's a Saturday, sometimes it can be Friday or Sunday. So basically last week before competition, you have two trainings to go, Monday, Wednesday, or Tuesday, Thursday, and that's usually light, easy trainings, right? So we don't count last week as actual training week. It's basically your recovery and rest before competitions. No any serious plans for last week. And then we need, well, at least 4 weeks on competition weight bells to get ready for our main test. So that's how you can see we have, well, if we take 12 weeks, we have 7 weeks on competition weight bells. Well, if we talking about competition on 32 kilogram bells. And first 5 weeks we have for increasing weight and get to training cycle. That's like entering to your training cycle. And if you are professional division athlete, if you compete on 32 kilogram bells, and if that's not your very first training cycle in your life, it's where, well, if you remember my strategy plan programming, it's where your year number 2 or 3. Well, I mean, when you know that you, well, can do 10-minute set and you just work on your pace and improving your technique. So this way, well, you use these first 5 weeks to start from lightweight bells. And well, I'm usually start with 20 kilogram bells. Sometimes I can start with 24. It's okay to start with 16, but again, just make sure that timing is right. And if I will start with 20, so it's, well, I basically count backwards. So I probably will spend 1 week on 30s, 1 week on 28s, well, maybe 1 week on 26s, and then we'll have, well, 2 weeks left for 20s, 22s, and 24s, which means just basically just 2 training per week. As I was mentioned before, we usually don't do 10-minute set with competition weight bells, but we can do 10-minute sets with the lighter weight bells. And this first 5 weeks, when we're increasing weight from lights to competition weights, kind of classic formula, if we'll do 10-minute set with on 24s and 10-minute set on 28s. So it will be like end of the second week and end of the fourth week. And the interesting thing about it is we shouldn't hit PRs, our PRs with this weight of the bells in this training cycle. Because you see, we are on our way to 32s. And that's a different story when the whole training cycle built for 10-minute set on 24s. That's when we have enough time to build up the pace and hit our absolute best. Or whole training cycle built for 28. But when it's just on the beginning of the training cycle, idea of these sets mostly to feel the time, to feel the distance, to feel these 10 minutes. And of course, we are not in our best shape at all here yet, because it's only, you see, first months of the preparation. So that's why, just don't worry about your previous PRs. Don't, you know, feel embarrassed or something to show numbers that lower than your absolute best on this belt, because you just want to get through these 10 minutes, feel the pace, feel technique great. So that's the target. You see, right now we have a table here, and it's just an example. What it means is, ideally, everyone who do kettlebell sport seriously should have his notebook where he's recording each training that he did. And if it's just a hard copy, it probably should be a last page. If you do it in Google Docs or Excel, it should be just an extra page where you keep records of your PRs with each single weight of the belts with 2 kilogram increment. And I showed the example of my PRs in long cycle with belts from 16 to 40 in 10 minutes. And you're working on this table through your whole sport career. And even if we look on my numbers, I don't like yet is my result on 26s. You can see it's just, you know, almost have no sense between 152 on 24s and 120 on 28s, so only 106. But that's kind of weight of the belt that you never really taking seriously. It's somewhere, you know, on your way to 28 or to 32s, and seems like I just never really push it hard. So I did this sense, but never did it for my best. And probably, that's kind of just a note for me, that maybe at some point when it will be nothing to do, I will try to just really focus on 26 and see how far can I go with these belts. But why I'm showing this table is, that's one of the options where you do 10 minute set with 24s and 28s. But if you, for example, have a blank spot on 20s and you never ever did 10 minute set with 20s before, so you can try to make 10 minute set with 20s on this training cycle. Or you never did 10 minute set with 30s, so you probably can put it somewhere, you know, maybe by the end of the week number 6. And again, kind of general idea is that you shouldn't do 10 minute set with each light weight of the belt through your training cycle, but at least 2 10 minute sets will be nice to have. And which weight you will do for it, it's up to you. You can decide based on your experience and your PRs on other weights of the belts. That was a tactic programming for jerk and long cycle. And again, just wanted to say a few words, kind of final words, about long cycle and jerk programming is, as you can see, this 8 or 7 minute long tests 2 or 3 weeks before basically means the peak of our condition through the training cycle. That's where we get to our best shape and hardest trainings. And that's quite a unique thing about long cycle and jerk, especially compared to snatch. That, this plateau, it's probably explained by also weight factor of long cycle and jerk training, because it's two belts and weight is quite heavy, and we're working here not only on our endurance and technique perfection and accuracy, but also building up strengths. And since we get there, we're able to maintain our best shape for 3 weeks. That's how it's usually work. And in long cycle and jerk, we have some delta, like if we get sick or something, to kind of maintain the great shape and still show the best result on competitions. So again, in long cycle and jerk, we're able to stay on the peak of our condition about 3 weeks long. But it's different to snatch. We cannot maintain that long the peak of our condition in snatch. And my explanation for that snatch is a more technical exercise, and well, it's not as much as not that much of weight struggle and pressure and snatch, but more like your mental endurance, accuracy, and well, if it's coming to strength, it's even not a dynamic strength and tiredness, but static work, because the pace is so high in snatch compared to jerk and long cycle, and well, of course it goes to grip. That's the main limitation in snatch, and what I experience by my own and what I can see from other lifters and my students, that when you're doing too much work on heavy weight, especially on heavy weight bells, you're at some point you realize that your forearm muscles have no enough time to recover between training, even if you do just three trainings per week. Tissue connections, it's almost like an inflammation processes start, and it just getting worse if you spend too much time on 32s, for example. And that's why, again, if you can see in long cycle and jerk, we increasing the weights and then kind of get to plateau and spend that much time on competition weight belts. Then in snatch, I prefer to have progression which is just a straight line up, where I'm using well, quite same amount of time with each weight of the belts, and my hardest set with 32s, that's my competition competition day. And it's very important in snatch to follow the protocol. And again, well, as I was mentioned before, like in jerk, long cycle, you have delta plus minus a week or two, that's okay, you will manage, you know, by adding some interval trainings and still stay in shape. But in snatch, if you will get to your peak on 32, 3 weeks before competitions, or even 2 weeks before competitions, I can say that you are in trouble, because you just will not be able to maintain that great shape for another 2 or 3 weeks. And that's kind of just awkward period of time, that it's too long to stay in shape and too short to reset and make another training cycle. So that's why in snatch, when I do programming, I need to know exactly the day of competition, and I planning exact amount of training per each weight of the bell, and I counting backwards my training. And that's what I did here as well. And when we take 12 weeks for preparation in, well, let's say if it's a biathlon example, and if it took 12 weeks for jerk, then well, if it's will be my situation, then I even don't need 12 weeks for snatch, and I will take only 8 weeks. And again, what it means that our first 3 weeks, excuse me, nine weeks total, and my first 3 weeks of training cycle will be jerk only, and only on the beginning of the fourth week I will start snatch with 16s, and exactly on competition day I will get to my 10-minute set with 32s. And in snatch, each weight I'm finishing with 10-minute long set. And this purple color, you can see 10-minute sets, kind of classic formula, but red options. That's what actually I prefer to do, is when it's 30s and 28s, quite heavy bells, not as heavy as 32s, but still you feel it on your grip, and well, you feel general tiredness after it. So I prefer to split left and right arm. So test for 30, not 10 minutes straight, but 5 minutes for right, rest, comfortable rest, 5-10 minutes, and then 5 minutes for left. Same 28s, I also split and rest between arms. And for very lightweight bells, it's even okay to go longer than 10 minutes, up to 14 minutes long for 16 kilogram and 12-minute walk with 18, well, 10-minute set with bells in between. And again, same story about pace, that here you're not chasing your absolute best numbers. And if you're going to all the way to 32s, well, let's say, in my example, if I'm kind of aiming for 200 reps, so it means that I'm looking for pace 20 reps per minute. And I don't need chase maximum pace on 16s. I will not go for like 25, 26, 28 reps per minute. I will go with my comfortable pace because, well, I shouldn't be slower than 20, but I don't need much above. And mostly, well, I will take this first light weights of the bells as my experience to polish and work on perfection of my technique, accuracy of insertion, accuracy of the catch of the bell for swing. So grip should feel no tiredness at all, like, you know, if you're professional athlete, all the way till 20s for sure. No challenge for your grip at all. It just should be all easy reps and you're just working on your technique. Again, it's just example of, again, my personal records, 16, 18, 20, and so far, kilogram bells. Again, even by these numbers, you can see that, well, I never really, well, compared to, let's say, numbers on 20s, even my numbers on 18 and 16 is lower. And it means that I never really push it, like, my max best, because, well, that's not the best that I use for competitions. 22s as well, numbers lower than I have with 24s. Reps is so high, and we also need to respect technique conditions and the conditions for competitions, fixation situation, and in snatch we are limited with this fixation portion. Because when you want to have a visible fixation, it's physically hard to go faster than 28 reps per minute. It's probably like physically you can snatch your bell above your head 30 times per minute, but it will be hard to need fixation on the head, so that's why I'm not chasing much this light weights anymore. We almost finished with tactic programming, and next stage for us will be local programming, where we will go exactly, well, inside of each week and each particular training, and we'll talk about like how exactly we spend time with the 16s, 18s, 20s, and for which sets we can do. And well, that's related a little bit with finishing of tactic programming for snatch. Because again, it's based on your experience in kettlebell sport, and I put here the classic formula where it's exact same amount of training per weight. But again, personally about myself, I can say that like for bells from 16 to 20s, well, I don't need, you know, 2, 3, 4 trainings. I usually just go for 10 minutes straight, 10, 10, 10, and then. Well, with 22s, 24s, I can spend a little bit more time. I can do about 2 or 3 trainings. And then with bells 26, 28, I can increase amount of training a little bit more to 5. And then with 28s, 30s, 32s, I can do full size micro cycles, about 6 training blocks. So that's why, again, if I look on my training cycle, we can see that I spent a little bit more time on 32, 30s, 28s, and a bit less time with 16s. But again, that depends on your experience, how confident you feel yourself in this exercise. If you're just on your beginning of your career and you're still not sure about, you know, performing the time with competition weight bells, you probably still need more training on the lightweight bells just to gain this experience and work on your technique. Few words about balance of jerk and snatch and biathlon preparation. And actually, well, these graphics will help me to explain the situation, because there's a different approach of biathlon training, and some of us, like, they split jerk and snatch training to different days. I prefer to do it same day. And when bells light, of course, that's affordable, but still, of course, biathlon training is harder than long cycle because you have two exercises at the same training, and you did the volume of jerk and you're not done yet. You have a snatch to go. But again, when it's light weights, it's kind of okay, but when bells get heavier, how you manage these two exercises. And by this programming, you can see that when you're on your peak of the training cycle and jerk, you're still on just 26s, 28s in snatch. And that's how you can manage them together. And when training in jerk starts to get easier, that's where the hardest training in snatch starts. So this replacement kind of make it work together at the same training. And mostly, well, you have a problem to keep jerk and snatch together all the way to like final 3 weeks, because again, even like this week's on the middle, you're on 22s, on 24s, while you're on 32s and jerk. And last training can be quite hard and challenging, and as exception, that's okay from time to time, maybe to split jerk and snatch to different days. Again, mostly, you should do your best to manage them together because you will compete on the same day, jerk and snatch. But again, I say when trainings are really hard here, that's okay to move the snatch to the next day. Thank you for watching and see you next time.